With me is Meg Brew, the latest addition to Lake County Extension. She's a new livestock agent. Welcome, Meg.
Hey, Julie. It's great to be here.
Actually, you do livestock, and you're also working somewhat with youth and livestock programs, and that's what we're going to talk about today.
That's correct. I spend about 20% of my time with youth, and because youth is the future of agriculture, that becomes a very important part of my job.
So tell us about a little bit about some of the programs that you're working with and why it's important for youth to work with animals, not just livestock, other animal projects.
Okay. Well, I should start by giving you some background about 4-H for those viewers who are not familiar with it. 4-H stands for Head, Heart, Hands, and Health, and it is the nation's leading positive youth development organization. We've been around for over 100 years, and we started with this drive to educate youth in a natural setting with agriculture and hands-on learning, and we've continued today with that same mission. So Lake County is currently home to a wide variety of animal projects, ranging from your pocket pets all the way up to 1,800-pound draft horses.
So what's a pocket pet?
Pocket pet could be things like hamsters, gerbils. I've had a youth do a hedgehog breeding project. So just about anything can be a livestock project.
So I guess with hedgehog, the answer is how do you handle them? Probably very carefully.
Very carefully, yes, and not when they're in a bad mood.
Did not know hedgehogs could be cranky.
Yeah. Okay.
So the hedgehogs are obviously not a typical...
Correct.
So what are some of the things that youth most commonly do?
The most popular projects in this area are swine, cattle, and horses.
So what if, for example, you don't have room, so you have to have a lot of space, obviously, if you're having a pig or a cow or a horse. So yeah. If you don't, then you switch to the pocket pets. Are there dog projects and cat projects?
There are dog and cat projects. And it is correct that for some of the larger species, you do have to have adequate room for the animal to live, and you have to remember to be a good neighbor and make sure that your neighbors are okay with you having a pig or a goat or
That's
whatever.
Probably the learning process.
Make sure that zoning is okay in your neighborhood association. But there are a variety of projects that don't involve living on a farm, and that's a mistake that people often make with 4-H, thinking that in order for my child to be involved in 4-H, I have to have land. I currently live in an apartment, and my son has a 4-H project living on our porch, which is our bunny rabbit. So there are lots of options for people who are not living on the farm. The other nice thing about 4-H is that a child like my son who lives in an apartment can be exposed to a variety of projects through club work. So while we don't have the pigs and the cattle in our yard, he goes to club meetings where he gets to see that and get exposed to that, which is really very nice.
And I know your son's young, so what age group do they potentially start with animal projects?
Well, 4-H starts at age 5 and goes through age 18. The 5, 6, 7, and 7-year-olds are what we consider clover buds, which means that they do the smaller animals, like the bunnies and the chickens and the pocket pets. They also are not competitive at that age because research has shown us that kids at that age don't really understand competition. So they're very happy just to get their green participation ribbon.
And to raise their bunny.
And they don't need to worry about first, second, and third yet at that age.
So on some of the large animal projects, what are some of the goals when a youth is raising the swine or horse or cow?
Well, they have a variety of goals, and goal setting is a really important part of 4-H. And the youth are encouraged to, at the beginning of the project, to really kind of think about what their particular goals are, their individual goals. But some of the goals for the market animals would include things like raising an animal that's going to be able to be sold at the market for meat and provide nourishment for America's families. So they go through the whole project all the way from having a young animal, going through handling it, vaccinating it, taking care of it, getting it to an appropriate weight and amount of fat cover. They show it, and then after the show, it is processed and sold as a carcass.
And a lot of times they have auctions. I know I've been
to
the fair. They auction them off.
They do, yes, they auction them off. And so community members can actually come to the fair, and rather than going to a local grocery store to get a beef, you can actually buy beef there. You'd have to have a sizable freezer or be able to split it up with your neighbors because it is sold as a whole animal.
And a lot of the youth bank the money. They have an animal every year, because I know people that have an animal every year, and the youth bank their money, and they use that money to, A, obviously they have to pay for the feed, but they also use that money to save for their education.
Absolutely, and that's the community members who are bidding on these animals are paying above what general market price would be as a donation to the youth, and a lot of youth have been able to go on to college or to continue in their animal projects because of the generosity of our communities.
So are the people, the youth that are involved in animal projects, do they all go into agriculture after they've raised their animals?
Well, some of them do, and we're always encouraging of that. We always need more farmers and ranchers. But many of them don't, and that's fine too. whether they go into actual active farming or into an allied industry or into an industry that has nothing to do with agriculture, all of us eat. So all of us are involved in agriculture in some way, shape, or form. And kids who've gone through 4-H have a much greater understanding of and appreciation for where their food and fiber comes from.
So it just doesn't come from the grocery store?
No, it just doesn't come from the grocery store.
So how do you get parents involved in it, or why would a parent even want to get their child involved with in an animal project?
Well, so many reasons, and so many parents already have pets at home, and turning that pet into a 4-H project is a way to turn Fido into something that's teaching responsibility and record keeping and make it more of a productive part of your family. For kids with larger animal projects, it gives an incredible sense of responsibility and also self-esteem. When you consider that a child is able to, you know, an 80-pound child can push a 1,200-pound show steer around, it makes things like bullying and peer pressure seem a lot more conquerable.
That's true. I guess if you're used to dealing with a 1,200-pound steer, the bully at your school isn't nearly so intimidating.
Yep, especially for teenage youth who are facing a lot of outside pressures. It really helps to have the barn to go home to and spend time with these animals and kind of develop a better sense of self through working with the animals.
That's true. You know, they're always there and you could talk to them and they don't talk back to you and they just like you for who you are.
That's true.
Even if you are just feeding them.
Yeah, absolutely.
So you mentioned showing at the fair. What are some other places where youth might? I know that there's horse shows that are related
to 4-H. There are. In Lake County, we have two horse shows a year. We have one in the fall and one in the spring. We also have a district horse show and a state horse show and a regional horse show, so it goes all the way up to the national level. With livestock projects, youth have the option of showing at our county fair. There is a Central Florida fair and also the state fair in Tampa. There are various 4-H dog shows throughout the year, rabbit shows, poultry shows. So there are a lot of opportunities. But in addition to showing, a lot of youth get involved in community service with their animals as well.
What kind?
So they'll take their animals to a nursing home, say, or around to different schools. We do Ag in the Classroom activities, and I've had youth come out with their steers and bring the steers for kids who normally don't get exposed to that sort of thing to be able to see.
So what is Ag in the Classroom? Is that a 4-H project?
Well, it's through the Department of Agriculture, but it's something that we are involved in, which is teaching the young people in public schools about the importance of agriculture. So 4-H has played a supportive role in doing that.
So it's just kind of an ancillary event that teaches all youth, not just 4-H youth, about the importance of agriculture.
Exactly, which is really important that we develop that in our young people, because our food just doesn't come pre-shrink-wrapped from the freezer container. So we need to know where it comes from and be poised and prepared to support the people that make it.
Right. So if somebody's wanting to get involved in a project, either large or small, what should they do?
Well, the first step is every county in Florida has a 4-H office, which is part of your cooperative extension service. So contact your local county office and speak to the 4-H agent or 4-H administrator, and they will put you in touch with a club that best fits your needs. And from there, it's just learning as much as you can and exploiting your resources. You'll have club leaders and other club members, as well as folks like myself, like the livestock agent and other extension agents who are there to help you succeed.
Well, thank you.